How do we make the different parts of the game engine and gameplay talk to each other? Events are a powerful tool I wanted in my game engine from the start. The way I implemented them, they come in two flavors. Immediate events. Once the event is sent out, it's immediately processed by the subscribe functions. Something like, I like the video, so I'll immediately like and subscribe. And an event queue, which holds events. They get added to the queue until we want to process them. At that point, all the subscribers process the events one by one, and we clear out the queue. Something like, I liked the video, I know I'll press like and subscribe, but I'll wait until the end of the video. These allow us to send messages across the entire engine, and react to these messages in any way we want. But why do we need or want that? Let's take a look at a simple example. In our small game, we have a tower that shoots projectiles at enemies. When the projectile hits an enemy, we want to do a bunch of different things, like play a sound, spawn particles, remove the enemy health, and so on. If we were to write this specific gameplay logic into the core collision checking code, the collision checking would become a big gameplay specific function, instead of a little reusable general function. So, instead of having all this logic in one place, we can separate the engine core collision checking and gameplay reactions by sending out an event when a collision happens. That's all the engine layer has to do. All it takes care of is knowing when a collision happened and telling us that it did. The gameplay code then subscribes to this event and responds accordingly. This isn't something original I came up with. It promotes two classic programming principles, responsibility and decoupling. From the point of responsibility, is the code that checks if a collision happened responsible for reacting to the collision? I don't think so. The engine core doesn't need to know how the game is supposed to react once a collision happens, only tell us that it did happen. The code that's responsible for the reaction should be the gameplay code that subscribes to the collision event. There, we can play the sound, remove health, spawn particles because that's specific to the gameplay. And for the decoupling, I like to write the engine and the game as two separate layers. Since I'd like the engine to be reusable as much as possible, I wanted to make it so that we can communicate between two layers nicely and effectively. Now, any gameplay code for any game I write can have its own logic on what to do when collision happens. There's a question if it's better to have 5 functions each subscribe to the collision event, or one bigger function that calls 5 other functions. The way I'm doing it currently, it might be more performant to have less subscribers, but we'll see once we try to use it on a larger scale. Also, there's a point of, I just wanted to implement this on my own. It's so much fun to write these things I always just hear about from blog posts, and actually see that it does something. This little gameplay demo is actually using exactly the setup from this video. When we click on the cube, we send an event through the code and react to it. I always love the weird little architecture pieces in custom game engines. If you have any, share them in the comments. I always like reading about fun design solutions. Yeah, go and build your own little game engine. It's fun and you'll learn a lot. Thank you for watching. Subscribe if you want to.